Up at the very top left of the Beyond window is your main Beyond windows slash states, these being Grid, Timeline, and Playlist. You can also switch to browsing the cloud, or even make your main window your Beyond Universe window. Timeline is where you can create timecode type shows and sequences. If someone gives you a show file or a timeline, this is where you can view, play, and edit them. To open or save a show, go to File, Open or Save to open Windows Explorer to save your show or open a show. Up top are some basic buttons that you use all the time. Save quick saves the current timeline. Undo undoes your last edit. Start moves your player head to the beginning. Previous goes to the previous edit point on the timeline. Play, which also turns into pause, starts and stops the timeline at the playhead. Next goes to the next editable point. End moves the playhead to the end of the timeline. You can use from and to create a smaller loop area within your whole timeline. Playing in this area will loop the player inside of the two from and to points. Preview opens up an extra window where you can preview each track, projector, or get an extra advanced preview window. Video opens the video playback window if your timeline has video media on it. Scroll makes the audio play and scroll as you move your playhead. All the way to the right, we have another toggle button called Show It Now. You must click this for your show to output, as well as enable laser output. This allows you to work in dark and make live edits to your timeline without having to output the show to your projectors. Next, you can see the different show tabs you have open and select which to work on and switch between the two. Note, you can only have one playback on one timeline at a time. You can also right-click on these tabs to close the show tab, add a new show, or edit the properties of that show. Under Show Properties, you can name and identify your show, decide how to measure time, the timeline's BPM, and any beginning beat offset you need. You can also follow the system BPM for the timeline. You can click this to have no output at 0 minutes and 0 seconds, even if your show has cues that run up against 0 minutes and 0 seconds. And ignore media track timecode if you want to change its speed or your audio track has variable bitrate. Lastly, under the General tab, you can add a time shift in case there is a delay from playback to your sound system you want to compensate for. Under Timecode Input, you can enable this show to follow timecode and give it an offset if needed. Under Timecode Output, you can enable this show to output timecode to use Beyond as the master. Note, you must set up timecode devices and input and output types in other areas of Beyond, which is covered in separate videos. The Information tab gives you information about your show, like time frame, events, and what projection zones are being used. Now inside of an actual show, we have our clock, the timeline itself, and our tracks. When you move the playhead across the timeline, you can see the clock change. We can zoom in by scrolling in on our mouse or out on our mouse, which will follow based on where our mouse is. Using this bar here, you can also zoom in and out. You can also extend the timeline using this button all the way to the right. On the left, we have our tracks. There are three types of tracks in Beyond Timeline. AV Media Tracks lets you import music, video, photos, and more onto the timeline. Laser Tracks is where you create and put all of your laser cues and animate. And buses are overall effect lines for groups of laser tracks. To add any of these, you can right-click on any of the tracks to add a new track. As well, each laser track can have effect tracks, where you can place an effect-only event on that specific laser track. Inside the tracks, you have a few buttons. You can expand or compress the track using this arrow, and even change how this expansion is viewed. And you can use this square on AV media tracks to lock the media to the top, so if you need to scroll down, the audio track will always be visible. At the bottom, you have a couple options for how things click, move together, and mark your timeline up. Edit mode is where you'll spend most of your time. This allows you to click and edit all of your timeline events. Draw event mode lets you click down and drag on the timeline to create the timing for your events. The magnet icon buttons select how you want your events to snap to timing. If you want them to snap to time heavily, use the big magnet. If you want to snap to the smaller increments of time, use a smaller magnet. If you want to have no snapping and move your events into millisecond timing, click the no magnet button. The last button is where you enable time markers. Click this to enable them. A window will open informing you about how they work. You can use your keyboard to set different colors onto the timeline, when the timeline is playing or paused. you can hit your keyboard while this is enabled to place markers down onto your timeline. The color corresponds to the colors across your keyboard. Events can be snapped to time markers, and then you can move many events at once using the time marker. Now we can discuss how to create content in the timeline. To import AV media, double-click on anywhere in the track to open up a window to open files. Select which file you would like to import and click open. You can click and drag this file around on the timeline and shorten it from the end. Right-clicking on AV events shows a few interesting things we can do, but we'll focus on volume and pan envelope. This will allow you to change the volume and the left-right balance of the track over time. You can add laser content to tracks in many ways. First, by double-clicking on a track to create an event and create something on the timeline. You can drag cues from your workspace, or the best way, use the cue list. We'll discuss the cue list in a moment. Each laser event in the timeline has 7 basic effects built in by default. These are normal beyond key effects, where you can create keys in your time to change the values. Beyond will then blend the cue between those 2 keys. Double-click on an effect. This will create a key and open up a small window to enter your values for that key. Once you click away from that window, your key will be set. You can also move keys by clicking and dragging them. Lastly, you can change how Beyond will animate between keys by right-clicking on the second key and placing an acceleration type. Effect tracks can be added as so. Here you can create effect-only events. Now let's talk about 4 more tab areas you will want to use when using Timeline. First is the cue list. This is like a small workspace for your timeline show. You can create cues in here, then drag them into your timeline events to link the cues between the cue list and the event in the timeline. This is super useful if you copy and paste a whole section to change the color later on for events at once. Similarly, this can be done with effects. You can add an effect in the effect list and drag those into events and bind them to that effect. Later, you can change the effect and it'll change all of the bound effects in the timeline. Now, on the right, you will see 2 tabs, first being called Effect. Here, this will display the effects in the selected event or the selected effect in the effect list, similarly to everywhere else in Beyond. You can also edit them here if you'd like. The last tab that is important in the timeline is the Event tab. This gives you a whole slew of options from timing, masking, PangoScript, and more for every single event in the timeline. There's a lot more to Beyond Timeline, however, this tutorial should get you through most of the show critical elements you may encounter with Timeline. To learn more, watch our long form video on Beyond Timeline, and if you still need support, you can contact our support team by emailing support@pangolin.com. Thanks for watching.